What is up, you guys? Megan here with another video, and for this video, we're going to be taking a look at Pentatonix's next sing-off performance. It's the fourth one in the series, and I'm very excited. Now, unfortunately, a couple of you guys already mentioned this in the last video. I don't think that I can actually include the sound in this, so what I would recommend is like in another tab or another window on your computer to just have the original video playing, which I will link down in the description, but have that playing while I'm like reacting to it, or you can just like watch me without any sound. It's going to be sort of weird, but like I can't really help it. I don't want to get like taken down, so yeah, that's what we're rolling with. So without further ado, let's get right into the reaction.
Putting their spin on a top,
I'm excited for this.
Pentatonix failed to impress the judges.
The risky arrangement didn't quite work for me, and the appeal of the song was abandoned in making that choice.
Oh yeah, the last one was like kind of iffy.
We just know we need to work really hard because it's a new game each week.
This week we're doing Believe by Cher.
I kind of have an issue.
Cher's really hard.
With our arrangement is that we've been struggling with
but
the
I'm
tempo.
Guessing they might change it because of the title. I don't know.
Be careful and take what bends into heart and not stray from the song too much.
We're taking the song really seriously, but they want it to be guilty pleasure. They want it to be fun.
I think we need to bring something different.
Guys,
it's so cool to see like behind the scenes.
We only have like 2 days. We shouldn't change it up.
Sonos was going to do Video Killed the Radio Star if they made it to Guilty Pleasure Week.
It was so hard to see Sonos go home. We've gotten so close to them. They're what we want to be, so we're doing it in their honor.
Oh, see, they did switch the song.
I don't want the fear of critiques to affect our performance, and it's really scary because one wrong move can cost us our dream of winning the sing-off.
It's very stressful because we don't know if we'll get it to where we really want it to be. I don't want to leave.
I'm excited.
We're pretty nervous about switching our song, but we're going to take risks because that's what we do. We just hope America and the judges like it because it's a week that we have to show that we're in this to win this.
Trying to tune in a killer performance with the new wave hit Video Killed the Radio Star by the Buggles, here is Pentatonix.
Yes!
I heard you on the wireless back in 52. Lying awake and tuning in on you. If I were young, it didn't stop you coming through.
Wait, dynamics are actually like pretty on point right now. And they're like dancing, like. Oh, that, whoa. Oh, that was cool. I like that. A lot better than the last one. That was a lot better than the last one.
All right, Pentatonix. Let's go ahead and go to the judges. Sarah.
That was awesome. I think you guys did what you do so well, really well, in that performance, and that is that you make really distinct, specific, meticulous choices, and you just deliver them. Your drum and bass section
so
is
good,
just so solid. And Scott, I think you showed a lot of restraint, and I really appreciated that. And I know that you guys made this song choice based on your buddies in Sonos, who, yeah, which I think that is, Well, I love that. There's so much camaraderie here, and we all make such really close connections with each other, and I think it was really neat to see you guys representing your buddies, and I thought that was really cool. There's just really a lot of ear candy there, and it was great.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Sean?
Oh, man. Pentatonix, I think you guys were sent back from the future to save a cappella and do it in a futuristic way.
Hey,
that
like
this 80s.
This is so weird to see like where they are now.
Saturated
and like,
you know,
all that they've been through.
Music is, you know, right up you guys' alley, because this is what acapella
because,
is all
like,
about.
We
it's
know what happened to
the
them,
limits,
but we're like
pushing
watching
the envelope
from
and
the
seeing
past, you know?
What else you can do outside of the traditional, and you guys got a grasp of that. Good job.
Ben, your thoughts?
Yeah, you've definitely hit on something with this one. There's a looseness about it that just really suited you. Scott, great voice, and the stylings on it, that's kind of radical because it's such a nerdy song, and yeah, you've got the nerdy glasses, but your voice, I don't know who else has those in here, but they're probably nerds too, and you're, you know, you're doing that's radical because you didn't kind of go robotic on the vocal. You actually delivered a vocal that was kind of, you know, had some soul to it that was really great. Every once in a while, you're on top of the beat. For such a great rhythm section, just when you get excited, you don't need to go on top of the beat. It's still exciting. Great work.
All right. Thank you, judges. We'll find out later if Pentatonix will advance. Thank you, guys. Nice job.
Yeah, that was actually so much better than the last performance. I am so, like, shocked because I was actually waiting for, like, the moment where the switch happens, like, where the, like, step up happens, because obviously we know, like, at least I know, like, now that, like, how they sound. I know, like, in the next, like, 4 or 5 years after this, like, how they sound and how, like, great they are, but it's very, like, hard to pinpoint exactly like where you do make the next step. So I think this fourth performance was probably the like particular first step that they took towards like becoming like Pentatonix as they are now, which is so cool to see because you don't normally get that. I think that's like that's so interesting. For some strange reason, the first person that like popped into my head when I like am thinking of like artists that like you can see like develop and see like actually get better, for some reason is Justin Bieber. So I'm not like the biggest fan of Justin Bieber just because I don't know, like, I mean, his songs are amazing, but they're not like amazing, you know. But I gotta say, like, the last album that he put out was so much significantly better than the rest of his, like, work. Like, don't get me wrong, it's not that I, like, hated his other songs. Like, I think they're still, like, super jamming. But, like, the fact that the last album was so significantly better than the rest of his work, like, is so cool to see because, like, you actually see this particular person, like, literally grow and, like, literally, like, get better through their music. So if you, like, listen to one song that he produced, like, 5 years ago, and then you listen to, like, one song that he produced, like, 1 or 2 years ago, like, the difference is incredible. And so the same thing is happening here, where, like, you can listen to, like, the first performance, and then you listen to this performance, and you see, like, the big difference and the big growth. So it's, like, very interesting. I enjoyed this a lot. I think this was super cool. So, yeah, I'm excited for the next performance. Sorry about, like, not including the sound. I know that's kind of annoying, but I just didn't want to get, like, the video taken off my channel. So that's, yeah, a compromise that I had to make. That's basically all I got for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're not already. Go follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And go friend or fan me on YouNow. I'm trying to live stream a little bit more. But that's basically all I got. You know what to do in terms of requests. Just let me know. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys are having a great day or night, depending on whenever you're watching this. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.